Hey guys, Michael Abraham here. My nickname is Wajang, but my closest friends call me the Iguana Whisperer. I'm teaming up with the Iguana Man over in Florida to import iguanas from Florida into Trinidad. When I was a kid, a guy once gave me an iguana as a pet, and I swear to you, to this day, that was the best pet I ever had. This is my son Julian. My parents always taught me to love, appreciate, and coexist with nature, as well as to respect the wildlife and the environment. And I would love for my kids to do the same.
Thank you, Uncle Fish.
So here we go.
Okay,
again.
So back to the purpose of this video. I've done quite a bit of iguana removal, relocation, and release. And I've also been following the problems that have been going on in Florida, Puerto Rico, and the Cayman Islands with respect to iguana population concerns. And it's so ironic because right here in Trinidad, we got the opposite problem. Iguanas are now a protected species due to their rapid decline in population, mostly due to the lack of sandy soils for laying their eggs, as well as from overhunting, both during and out of the hunting season. In my lifetime, I've seen our local porcupine as well as our local red rocket deer become endangered, and I do not want to see the same thing happen to the iguanas. Okay guys, so here's how I see it. According to recent research, humans have cleared down over 80% of the world's forests to date, and that number is increasing. That is crazy in my opinion. No wonder the iguanas have no other choice but to eat our crops and ornamental plants. Even though iguanas are deemed invasive in some countries, everything and everyone is invasive in a way. We gotta take the good with the bad. Aside from being able to feed a bunch of hungry people, iguana meat is actually prized as being medicinal and good for the human reproductive system. Not like we need any more help with overpopulation. Iguanas also disperse seeds and forest plants with their feces, as well as control overgrown vines that often smother trees. Aside from that, they actually make some people happy with their friendly and curious behavior. It just so happened that Raj the Iguana Man reached out to me on Facebook to see if we could import iguanas from Florida into Trinidad to help resolve their issues as well as create balance. So I went to Florida this one time and I saw this huge fluorescent, iridescent, blue and red iguana on the side of the highway. And I thought I was seeing things till I went up on Instagram and did some more research on the varieties. And then I found out about Tom Crutchfield as well as a couple other breeders. And I was amazed to see what these guys were doing with iguanas and the type of results they were getting. And that was when I found the Iguana Man on YouTube.
Today's episode of The Iguana Hunter.
Luckily, to this day, we have linked up and we're going to try to make this possible. Okay, so side note, even though I mentioned all these cool varieties, it is very important that we do not change the breed of iguanas that we have here. So stay tuned. I know this, but look at the advice I'm about to get. Okay guys, today I'm getting ready to go into the Forestry Division Wildlife section here in Trinidad to find out more details on how to import iguanas from Florida into Trinidad. Let's see how it goes. Good day, I'm calling to find out who I need to speak to about something like importing iguanas from Florida into Trinidad. Right. Okay, thanks a lot. Farm Road? All right, I'm gonna head across there now. Thank you very much, bye. Okay, so what the lady on the phone said is that I gotta go in, fill out a form, and the people who have to review it will see if it's possible or not. So let's go, let's get going.
Just thank you for your loving kindness, for every drop of air I breathe. And for waking me up this morning, and when I'm trotting in the streets today, please, Jaja, never leave my side. And every day the same prayer I say, and I'm saying it to one more time. Yeah, trotting in the streets I pray, Jaja, beg you please, never left I in mind.
Oh,
never. so far I see, my eyes I can't see all the possible things people could be. Judge I be my guide, cause I can only protect my flesh. But people wear disguises, help me realize, teach me love unconditionally. Can't go around preying everybody. Closest of friends will deceive you badly. I learned that Rastafari is my family. So when I'm traveling on the streets today, please, Judge, I never leave my side. And every day the same prayer I pray.
Yeah, that's how
to
actually. Okay. So here you have a tree. Right, a tree on the
road
that's
supposed to be here. Right. This is the country or the business place and address. Right.
You have
to
put here.
Okay.
Because we're seeing our face.
Sorry, sorry. No. Edit, yeah, edit.
When the
All right, y'all. So I just spoke to Shelly and she was very helpful. Basically, she gave me a phone number to call back. So I need to call back this person later to give them the details as well as to find out more. And then I got to fill out this form. And I'm going to submit this separate form. And apparently when you import any animals, they have to go straight from the plane to the veterinary clinic for quarantine or whatever. So I'm gonna go ahead and try to organize that as soon as possible. And yeah, see. So the next step is to call Anna, which I will do for you guys on speakerphone. Yeah, Mr. Singh doesn't work on a Monday or a Tuesday, so in that case, I usually go right there to that little shop and get some vegetables. It's in the middle of St. James. Okay, so I was told by Shelly Ann to call Anna after 12 p.m. It's now 12:08 p.m. I'm just preparing a couple of questions for her. One is, well, the reason for import. So our reason would be breeding and conservation. So I would also want to ask her if I'm doing something out of goodwill and conservation, if it's possible to get government assistance. Basically want to work this as best as we could to make it as easy as possible and to turn it into something good.
Hello,
is this Anna?
No, she's not in at the moment.
Okay, I'll call back later. Thank you.
You'd like to leave a message?
Sure. Could you tell her to call Michael?
Yes,
from Shelly Ann. Thank you. Bye bye. Okay. To Trinidad.
Hey.
And my first question was basically, well, the reason for import is for breeding and conservation. And I was basically wondering two things. One, the possibility, like how possible is it to get through with something like that? All right, and if it is something for... Okay, it's the first time. All right. All right, so once I fill out the forms, I drop it back to y'all there in Farm Road? All right, nice. Okay. All right, and then from there, I will get a call back. Okay, thanks a lot. Sorry, y'all, I wasn't expecting her call back so soon. So I had to switch phones and stuff. I wasn't really hearing what she was saying too good because there was a lot of noise in the background, as you guys heard. But one thing that stood out to me was that no one has ever done this before. So I thought that was pretty cool. And yeah, let's start the process to try and save some iguanas. So I have an idea. I know through experience that if you're starting off something you're not sure about, the best thing is to always ask for advice from people who may be familiar. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to call the El Socorro Center for Wildlife Conservation and see what advice they could give me. Let's see how this goes.
Hello?
Hi, good day. I was calling to find out some information or to get some advice about something. Well, I saw y'all once in Long Circular Mall. Y'all had an expo there. And I think I took down your number since then. Okay, so this guy I'm on the phone with, his name is Ricardo Mead. I was really impressed with how much he knew about iguanas. And he's an advocate for wildlife here in Trinidad and Tobago. You know, I'd love to team up with him one day. The conversation on the phone was way too long. We spoke for like half an hour. So I gotta cut out the conversation because you guys are gonna leave the video. You'll get bored for sure. So here are the key points. The first most important point is not to change the breed of iguanas that we have here in Trinidad.
We have certain problems with the iguanas in Florida. First, you have to do due diligence and check and make sure it is exactly what we have here, because now you risk hybridizing or creating a new species.
Right. The second point was to set up breeding enclosures, which he described the specs to me. He said you could have more females in there and just one male, because if you have more than one male, you'll get fighting.
Right.
Yeah, I have some pretty good video footage from right here in Woodbrook where I have a few of them. I wanna show you, man. The third point he suggested was just to do it all with locally bred iguanas. But the really bright green adults are really hard to find, obviously because they are spotted and hunted first. I also want to help save some of the iguanas in Florida, so I'm going to stick to what I'm doing. He also suggested that Tobago, which is the island next door to us, has a really nice breed of iguana, a bright, beautiful green. That's my buddy Kiwan, by the way. So yeah, I might look into getting some from over there also. And we definitely have an issue with our wildlife here in Trinidad. It's very sad.
Yeah. When you look at the Wildlife Association of Tobago also, the iguana is their symbol. And they're very much concerned because they're so serious decline in iguana population. So they're now very much interested in breeding iguanas.
The Tobago Wildlife Foundation is currently working on a project to increase their iguana population as the numbers have dwindled drastically. The fourth point he suggested was to beware of larceny and theft, because people here would risk their lives to catch an iguana. They would come in your property, they would trespass, they would do anything they could.
Okay, once people know you have iguana there, if iguana there, they don't get $300 to $500, they come in for that.
Correct. Definitely. Thanks, Ricardo.
All right, not a problem, man. You have a great day.
Yeah, bro, you too, bye.
All right, okay.
That was cool. Nice guy. I'm very excited because my neighbor where I work, Fish, just called me to say that he spotted some baby iguanas.
Right there on the noni plant.
We get very few survivors, but it's always great to see new life. Hey guys, I'm here filling out all the forms and I'm chatting with the iguana man on Facebook, basically trying to get all the information I need from on his side. They want to know the quantity we want to bring in, and I'm thinking of starting kind of small with, like, let's say around 10, just to make sure things run smoothly and most importantly to make sure they arrive here safely. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. So I'm gonna get it and drop these things off first thing in the morning.
Friends for real. This is how me feel. I will leave a door, me not condemn, not open. But me give thanks to who closed them. Because I know me try harder. Me I tell you, say I know me try harder. To all of the enemies, the force them. Me bust a drink and make a toast to them. Because I know me try harder. You me try. These are youth from the streets with
know about the white rice, we know type of meat. Every day poverty pull up like it depart.
So just wait for the call, right? And from there I guess I'll ask your question. Thanks a lot, bro.
Sweet, one pants, one shows, every name used to pay.
So no judge us a J Prince to it. Time to head back to work.
Pagans are telling power leap a door, we not condemn the open. But me give thanks to who claws them. Because I knew me try harder.
Right, back to work. So now we await the phone call. Right. Guys, sorry about that. That timing was terrible because my other phone died just as I was trying to record the phone call. So Mr. Mahabir called me. And what he was saying is that I have to do a proposal because they are concerned about introducing a foreign species to our local wildlife. I need to do more research about the species in detail, crossbreeding, all that sort of stuff. And they want to see evidence that if we do it and we start, it's within a controlled environment. Like I said, they sounded concerned about releasing foreign species into the environment. So this proposal is going to be a challenge. Oh, let's see how it goes. Okay, so I've done a ton of research on this topic and there are many different subspecies of green iguanas and many morphologies of iguanas, but I'm just going to keep it simple. Basically, we want pure green iguanas with no rostral horns and no red on them. These are a few green iguanas caught by Jessica from Iguana Solutions in Broward County, as well as Fort Lauderdale. So far, they seem to be identical to the ones we have here. Raj, bro, I just wanna say thanks for reaching out to me. I wish we could save all the iguanas, but I know that's impossible. And let's just do our part to make the world a better place. We need to share the planet because we're taking it over. If you or anyone you know could help us out with this process with respect to shipping rates, approvals, anything, share the video or please let us know. We also have a donation link as well as a Patreon link in the description below. And we could use all the help we could get, not just for this project, but also for other rescues. Thanks.